all that he has done for all of us. His acts of kindness and his death will not be left with unknown. We will always remember the sacrifice that he made for all of us, and especially for me. I have carried my life in a way that is noble, honest, and truthful. As a Christian woman, I can stand in front of you today and say, there is not a day that I do not live through that I recall that day vividly. I remember him in a way that none of you should ever have to remember him. I knew that he was dying. I knew that he would not make it. There is no greater sacrifice that anyone can give for anyone else than their life in line of duty or elsewhere.
Yeah, good to see you. How you been?
Hi, Pat.
No, that's mutual. Okay.
We never do.
I had
taken time to rest. I was chained to a tree. And he had laid his head back against the tree, and I thought, well, he's resting. Maybe I can get a nap too. But it was an unsettling feeling there, like something was going to happen or something was there that shouldn't be there. And just moments after that thought went through my mind, the dogs came apparent in the view of us. And I knew that we were in trouble, that things were going to not be good. And shots rang out, and it was from Hollandville. And I saw Terry Anderson being shot. I experienced him being shot. We weren't far away from him.
Where were you?
I saw the blood coming out of him. It spurt all over, and I knew then that his life was probably gone. And that was one thing that you pray for when you're abducted and when you're in a situation like I was in, that no harm will come to anyone, that everyone will make it out alive. And that wasn't to be. I think the hardest part of today was being prepared to do a good job, to honor him in a way that's proper. Words can always express how a person really feels, but today, with God's help, I think I got the right words at the right time, and they fulfilled the dream that I've always had, that I could honor them in a noble way today.